Thank you.
In this place, it needs to be not me, but our work package leader, Professor Bosco from Flensburg, but he can't participate for family health problems. So I need to present his presentation. So I need to talk about another person's minds. So be patient and maybe not exactly I will interpret it the same as he have in mind, but I will try. I was ordinary participant of the work package 3 and was not included in all activities which are here presented, so I will try to start. And few sentences to talking about Professor Bosco. He have just in this work package a lot of work, and I would say maybe this work package was the most difficult from all the project, and he very bravely have standing on this position of leader, and he try to avoid sharp angles when there was critical situation in some questions in some solvents. So he was a very good diplomatic person, and we have enjoyed to be in his work package and work together. So his presentation. Possibilities and impact of telemedicine. What will be presented as an introduction. You see here all work packages, and work package number 1 was project management administration, which was guided by Finland, so Ostrobotnia. VP2, communication and information, Vilnius University Hospitals and Tereškių Klinikos Lithuanian, and leader was Domantas Stundis. And this our work package, needs and strategies to counteract brain drain and professional isolation in remote primary health care through teleconsultation and telementoring. Flensburg, Germany, and VP4, implementation of teleconsultation for improved professional cooperation quality in remote primary healthcare, Sweden, Leckingen Institute of Technology, VP5, implementation of telementoring for career development of health professionals in remote primary healthcare, Iceland, and VP6, political awareness of strategies to ensure high quality and accessibility service in remote primary healthcare by means of e-health. There was such structure of those all 6 work packages. Sorry. And we have interconnection in such sequence between work packages. So the VP3 have special questions dealing with country-specific literature review, country-specific expert interviews, transnational focus group, teleconsultation 7 pilot regions in 5 countries, telementoring 5 pilot regions in countries, and some results of those pilots you will here have. Strategy and development, again, VP3, development of a transnational strategy paper from the findings on the theoretical background and the pilot regions, and VP6, early contact to political stakeholders to raise awareness. Sorry, something with my computer. I need to go.
It's disappeared from view.
Thank you. early context to political stakeholders to raise awareness on the prime KIT topics in joint political discussions. So those WECs were
sorry about it. It's some action.
It's not good.
No? Yeah. It does. It has animation inside, so you have to click several times.
Mm-hmm.
So it's
so how to
you can also push it here as well.
Clear. Okay, thank you. Be careful. Okay. As you see, all WECs in different WEC packages were linked together in such cycles, and we supported those WECs from different WEC packages. So, methodology. We have started in January, June 2012, and it was made literature review carried out in all seven countries, and a comparison of the seven reviews to reveal and differences and similarities in every country. Then in July-December 2012, expert interviews were made in about 10 interviews per country and 74 experts interviews in total. Comparison of the interview was made as well. And in June 2013, focus group discussion round table with one healthcare representative from each of seven countries on teleconsultation and telementoring. Yeah. And was main topics, as you know, brain drain, professional isolation, teleconsultation, and telementoring. What means for every country brain drain and professional isolation? During brain drain, we lost skilled professionals. They leave their native land. They try to find and seek more promising opportunities elsewhere. And we have a big lack of professionals and high qualified professionals in our countries. Professional isolation. When we lost our professionals, the professionals who left in our countries, especially in rural areas, are more aged, and communication for them is more heavy, and we have problems. We have isolation, professional isolation, especially for them. It can result in estrangement from the professional identity or feeling to have no one to turn to discuss and share professional issues and ideas. What main features we can stress in our findings? We can say that one of the reasons of brain drain and professional isolation is low salaries, lack of professional career opportunities, lack of knowledge dissemination in healthcare, lack of educational institutions, limited resources, county governments supports in different way those ideas. Large startup investment to open practice. Lower remuneration, that's right. Technical problems. Surely those developments of technical problems in every country differs as well, like in economical, but main are lack of IT technologies, insufficient infrastructure, poor accessibility, insufficient labor process organization, lack or poor quality of working tools, provision of certain services impossible, high bureaucracy. I think it's common for our all countries, I think. Personal social organization, geographical remoteness, bad image of rural regions, poor working atmosphere in healthcare, inadequate working conditions, missing job opportunities for partners, more single practices in rural regions, much responsibility, risk of being overloaded by work, lack of free time activity options, missing support by colleagues. Working conditions, medical doctor's latch job description, poor working schedules, poor working conditions, loss and lack of good co-workers, one-sided working content, population decline. It causes these problems. And social organizational, again, professional isolation, lack of social protection, low medical professions reputation in society, illusions about conditions in other countries. That was main reasons mentioned in our persons who are responsible for this field. So what we can find in literature and what we can extract from expert. Economical reasons, lack of professional career opportunities, lower remuneration, working conditions, insufficient labor process organization, insufficient infrastructure, poor accessibility, social organizational, lack of free time activity options, missing job opportunities for partners, missing support by colleagues. So what features we can find in literature which affect brain drain and professional isolation? A large amount of responsibility, decreased quality of care, inequality in healthcare provision, brain drain, decreased quality of care in inequality in health care provision, shortage of workers in health sector, deterioration, additional workload of work conditions for remaining physicians, immigrations in the country as a result for immigrants of health professionals, loss of training expenses for education, young health professionals, longer waiting times, increased isolation, increased workload for hospitals. So what expert stress, what effect we have on different levels, on patients, professionals, and services. Increased dissatisfaction by patients, decreased accessibility to primary health care, decreased quality of care, mistakes in the treatment process, patient safety, longer distance to the closest physician, longer waiting time, limited choice of physicians, negative attitude towards healthcare system and healthcare policy. For professionals, what that could mean? Risk of professional isolation for those who stay, labor force will disappear, professionals with the highest level of education are mostly likely to leave, that's right. higher workload for those staying, negative attitude towards healthcare system and healthcare policy, problems for general practitioners to refer patients to specialists if they are missing, to get highly quality feedback. Service, lack of local knowledge among health providers in larger competence areas, additional workload for hospitals, necessity of new ways of cooperation since units fade out and or selected local services, lack of services provision for primary care and so on, especially for laboratories. What we have in common context from those brain drain and professional isolation: decrease of quality of care or operation patient safety in common, prestige decrease of medical profession, increase of brain drain, increasing dissatisfaction with the healthcare system, influence the mental health of the isolated, stress, burnout, depression for the physicians. Professionals stick to old practice, resist change, and create protective walls. Reduced opportunities for professionals and personal development. Patients might think that familiar creates quality, although it does not. Next, financial. What solutions could be made against brain drain and professional isolation. Financial, increase doctor salary, but I think not in all countries and not every time. Increase funding directed to healthcare in general, establish additional financial support, particularly in rural areas. Social, increase social protection and prestige of doctor, develop good working conditions, improve infrastructure, transport, and schools. Organizational means train other professionals that support physicians and nurses, increase interactions and communication between health professionals, transform service structures from client-based into client-focused, establish teleconsultation and telementoring as a possible solution. Establish teleconsultation and telementoring as the possible solution. I would say it's a main task. And here, this is a movie made by Margarita Radžiūnienė, and it is talking about this GP from rural area consultation with
the patient has to go by car. He arrives to the healthcare center after 1 hour driving. Later, after meeting and discussed the symptoms with general practice doctor, patient got the answer that the general practitioner has had difficulties in diagnosing. So the patient is told that the general practitioner will call him later after discussing the symptoms with a colleague. The general practitioner is going through the health record of a patient to see the medical history, looking for anything that will help him determine the medical condition of a patient, but is unable to acquire a satisfying diagnosis. The general practitioner leaves the room to discuss with health center colleagues about the patient, but can get a satisfying answer. But there is not a lot of colleagues around, and not many nurses work here. The GP comes back to his room thinking about what to do. When he figures it out, he has heard about the option to make teleconsultation with a specialist in the hospital in the city. Normally, the general practice doctor would then refer the patient to a hospital or a specialist in the city who has more knowledge about the symptoms and the condition of the patient. This takes a lot of time and effort, especially if it's very far away or if a specialist is unavailable, which can prove to be detrimental to the health of the patient. And meanwhile, in the big city, in a large clinic, there is a doctor who has a lot of planned teleconsultation, is always willing to help for a young general practice doctor. With teleconsultation, the local general practice doctor can easily contact a specialist physician at the hospital in order to discuss his thoughts and uncertainties about a patient's medical condition. It's possible to exchange radiology images and offer required documents. And finally, teleconsultation saves both parts, the patient and also the physician, time and allows for more conclusive diagnosis and a quicker treatment. During video conference, young GP got all answers and diagnosis from specialists. Prime care ED, counteracting brain drain and professional isolation of health professionals in remote primary health care through teleconsultation and telementoring to strengthen social condition in remote Baltic Sea region.
So, what main positions should be mentioned in a strategy paper concluding all results from this our work? Define, consider challenges and requirements. Involve stakeholders into activities at an early stage of the implementation. Consider the different financial and legal issues in the different countries' healthcare systems. Purchase equipment. Ensure technical support throughout the implementation process. Enable well-suited training possibilities for the staff. So make main conclusions. All participating countries strongly believe that teleconsultating and telementoring enhance the working environment for healthcare professionals working in primary healthcare in rural districts. It is important to meet the requirement to change the attitude of health professionals and patients toward information communication technologies. The literature reviews, expert interviews, and also the pilot showed that piloting, teleconsultating, and telementoring counteract brain drain and professional isolation. Thank you for attention.